Tu vois là, le petit garçon, il pleure. Et là, il rigole. Alors, mets-moi le mouton. Regarde, le mouton en jaune. Voilà. Bravo, Enzo.
Annabelle is not a special needs teacher, but Enzo's mother. Since the start of the school year, she's been taking care of Enzo by herself in this small apartment in the suburbs of Paris.
T'as bien travaillé. Tiens, regarde. Bravo. Je prends un petit bonbon.
Enzo is unable to speak and has a mental disability. The 12-year-old spent years going to an outpatient hospital, but suddenly no institution has room for him.
It's been very difficult. Overnight, we found ourselves at home without any care, nothing. The child will become nervous and will regress. In the end, it will be very negative for him, the impact of being in this situation. I think it's criminal, to be honest.
And Annabelle isn't the only one in this situation. She's grown close with other families in the area. Together, they've formed a collective.
Ils peuvent pas rester à la maison, c'est pas vrai.
Un enfant qui reste à la maison, il perd tous ses repères.
The fact that Enzo is no longer in school is partially caused by a decision that, at first glance, seems to have nothing to do with him. But since January, Belgium has capped the number of places it offers to French adults with a disability.
The Belgian moratorium, that means there are more places for adults in Belgium. But it also means even less options for adults in France, because here nothing has been done. So the adults are occupying spaces in institutions that usually accommodate teenagers. As a result, the teenagers can't go back to these institutions, and therefore we end up with young people like Enzo, who is age 12, being stuck at home.
For decades, France relied on Belgium by financing the care of its disabled people across the border. Now the French state is looking to bring them home.
Officially, we say it's a scandal. We're going to put an end to this. But in reality, nothing is being done.
The policy shift is a cause for concern in Belgium, too. A few hundred meters from the border, 90% of the residents of this center for disabled adults is French. The director hasn't felt the effects of the moratorium yet, but fears having to lay off staff if the number of residents drops.
There are institutions that have long served handicapped people, whether they're Belgian or French, and it would be a shame to forget us. Because at the end of the day, we've been partners of the French, some of the homes for 50, 60, 70 years.
Pour certaines maisons, 50, 60, 70 ans.
All the participants of this garden and sense workshop are French. Originally from near Paris, Geraldine finally found her place here.
We removed the small branches from this branch. This is rosemary.
When she arrived in Belgium 25 years ago, Geraldine had a lot of psychological problems.
I adapt my workshop to the level of the residents. Today, with this group, there is Geraldine, who is someone with a fairly high level of autonomy and dexterity, so she can take apart the rosemary.
Bonjour, papa.
Geraldine's progress has been welcomed by her family.
Je suis contente de t'entendre.
Before being referred to this center, she'd gone through several institutions in France.
We found a place in Belgium where she stabilized. I say we don't want to change anything because there's been a lot of pressure to bring my daughter back to France.
The reimbursement of transport costs is another way to pile on pressure.
Alors, Louis.
Every Friday evening, a taxi brings David's son straight home from Belgium. Louis is severely autistic. But for some time, David has had to fight to get these round trips covered. This is appalling, he says, as he could only find a spot for Louis in Belgium.
The difficulty is that there is no space in France, and so at some point you don't have a choice. You have to make a decision. It was difficult for me and my wife.
As a healthcare worker, David wouldn't be able to afford these weekly trips without government help.
Every year, there is a new policy regarding transport. Will we be affected? We don't know. We wait. We are always on alert.
David can count on this French-Belgian for help. She started an association to help families in a similar situation.
There is endless red tape. Appeals take months. You have to launch a case, which you will win, but then sometimes takes months, even years. It's dragging on, so there are families who can no longer afford it. And in this situation, the child is left without options.
For now, Louis continues his weekly trips by taxi. But his parents, like many other families, fear that the decision to bring French handicapped people home risks upsetting the delicate balance they've worked so hard to build.
La banane.